Hello, Nurse Robbie here for the Epilepsy Foundation. Did you know that around 1% of the population has epilepsy? That's nearly 250,000 Australians living with epilepsy right now, which is more than the whole population of Hobart. For those that don't know or need a quick refresher, epilepsy is a condition that affects the brain, causing recurrent, unprovoked seizures. Despite how far we've come in our understanding and treatment of epilepsy and other neurological conditions, there is still heaps of misinformation out there. Let's bust some myths around epilepsy and build a better understanding of this condition so that we can reduce stigma and discrimination for those living with epilepsy. Myth 1. All people with epilepsy regularly lose consciousness and have convulsions. You've seen the TV shows and movies, right? Where someone falls to the ground and starts convulsing. Yet, needless to say, this definitely isn't everyone's experience with epilepsy. This type of seizure is called a generalized tonic-clonic seizure, and is just one of over 60 different types of seizure, many of which are much more mild than that. Other seizures involve quick muscle twitches, a brief loss of awareness, being a bit disoriented, confusion. Some are so mild they can even be mistaken for daydreaming. Myth 2. Epilepsy is a life sentence. While there is no cure for epilepsy, that does not mean it is a life sentence. Some types of epilepsy in children are self-limiting, meaning the child will outgrow it. Overall, 70% of people will have good control over their epilepsy with medication and may not experience any seizures. In fact, if someone hasn't had a seizure in 10 years and can stop their medication for 5 years, their epilepsy is considered resolved. Myth 3. Epilepsy is a mental illness. A neurological condition that affects the brain, like epilepsy, is very different to a mental health or psychiatric condition. Some people with epilepsy will develop a mental health issue like anxiety or depression. There's a lot of reasons for this, but it is not everybody's experience. Developing a mental health issue is actually more common for anybody with any chronic illness, not just epilepsy. So it's really important that you get this treated as well as treating the chronic condition. Myth 4. If you have epilepsy, you can't drive. If they are seizure-free on certain medications or meeting state guidelines, then someone with epilepsy can absolutely drive a private vehicle. The rules for driving commercial vehicles, like buses and trams, are a bit more strict, and if someone has had a seizure, they may not be allowed to drive these types of vehicles. Myth 5. You should restrain someone who is having a seizure. Definitely not. Restraining someone who is having a seizure won't stop it or protect them. It's actually likely to agitate that person, and it could harm both of you as well. What you do depends on the seizure. So if they're having convulsions, you try to move them out of the way of anything dangerous like stairs, or if they're on the floor, you put something soft under their head. Myth 6. You should put something in someone's mouth during a seizure to stop them swallowing their tongue. That's another no. Firstly, it's impossible to swallow your tongue. If you're lying on your back and the tongue muscle completely relaxes, it can block your airway though, and that's bad. Once the convulsions end, roll that person onto their side and tilt their head back to stop this from happening, but don't put anything in their mouth. The person can't control their muscles while having a seizure, and so they might bite down too hard on the object, breaking their teeth, or you could even get injured. Myth 7. If someone has a seizure, they have to go to hospital. Not all seizures require hospitalization. Some people just need a bit of time to rest and recover afterwards, and they can actually do this at work or at home. It really depends on the person and the type of seizure that they're having. If you see someone having a seizure and you don't know them, it's a good idea to call the ambulance because it's better to be safe than sorry. For more information on epilepsy, there are so many great resources online, including first aid for anybody having a seizure. These are available through the Epilepsy Foundation's website and have also been shared on nurserobbie.com thanks to the Epilepsy Foundation. Everyone's health is individual, and it's better to be informed rather than believing any myths. This way we can reduce the stigma faced by people living with epilepsy and other neurological conditions. And remember something I always say, there's no healthcare without self-care.